Due to which I was found as a referee.
Okay, good afternoon. Good afternoon again. Welcome everyone. Our speaker today, I think, does not need to be introduced. He's been here for about 1.5 years now,
yes,
as a postdoc. But anyway, he got his PhD 2013 in Korea University, and then he moved as a postdoc to City College of New York. Came here also as a postdoc, and in 2 weeks he's going back to Korea for a tenure track position at Chungbuk National University in Korea. And what he's going to tell us about today is about his latest two yet unpublished papers, but they are on the archive. Of it.
Okay, thank you, Maxi, for introducing. Okay, as Maxi said, it will be my farewell talk in this institute. And really, thank you for giving me this opportunity to give a talk and to introduce my research. Actually, 1.5 years ago, when I decided to move here, some people, including my previous boss, were worried and gave me an advice that Mallorca is too good place to study. Yes, half is true and half is false. It's just Mallorca is just good place to study. It was really good time and one of the best time in my life. I would like to thank you in everyone in this institute. Okay, in this talk, I'm going to talk about contagion processes, and this work is done with Maxi. Okay, contagion processes are found widely in our society, such as disease spreading, rumor spreading, and innovation propagation, and information spreading like that. And they affect critically our life, our daily life. So it is one of the main topics in science of complex systems. The main question in this topic is how and when a contagious entity propagates from a seed to a whole system. So in this talk, I will focus on this topic with several different settings. Okay, in general, contagion models can be classified into two classes, simple and complex contagions. Simple contagion is largely inspired by epidemic spreading. One of the oldest model of simple contagion is proposed in 1927 by Cormack and McKendrick. It's essentially the same as SIR model. So indeed, in the simple contagion model, is assume the pairwise interaction or dyadic interaction. So many epidemic models like SIR or SIS or other simple epidemic models belong to simple contagion model. So as I told you, this model is pairwise interaction and is really similar to bond population problem. So usually it shows a continuous phase transition between epidemic and non-epidemic phases. And another type of contagion process is complex contagion. It is largely motivated from social contagion of innovation or behaviors. maybe the one of the most famous complex contagion model is threshold model, proposed by Granovetter originally and adapted in network version by Watt in 2004. complex contagion assumed the group interaction or collective interaction. So in the complex contagion, multiple neighbors, a lot of multiple neighbors affect collectively. To be specific, in the threshold model, a node adopts an innovation if fraction of adaptive neighbor is larger than a certain threshold. So basically, it's collective interaction, and it typically threshold model or other complex contagion model show discontinuous phase transition. Okay, these cartoons show the difference difference between simple and complex contagions. Simple contagion model is pairwise interaction. So if an infected node contacts with a susceptible node, then with a certain probability, a susceptible node becomes an infected node by disease transmission. So SIS and SIR model belong to simple contagion model. But in complex contagion model, if a number of or a fraction of neighbors in adapted state is larger than a certain threshold, this node becomes adapted state. So in the complex contagion, multiple neighbor affect collectively at the same time to the node. So it's collective interaction, and many contagion model like threshold model, boosted population, or cooperative epidemic model belong to the complex contagion. Okay, so this is summary of comparison between simple and complex contagions. First, simple contagion is pairwise interaction, and only single exposure is needed for adoption. And typically, it shows second order phase transition, and many epidemic models are a simple contagion model. But complex contagion is usually collective interaction and multiple exposures from neighbors, from adapted neighbors are needed. And usually first order phase transition is found. And complex contagion can describe social contagion, usually. And traditional assumption is that contagious entity solely fully determine the type of contagion process. For instance, disease is simple contagion, social innovation is complex contagion. But our question is this assumption is true? So we can we check the how many exposures are needed for adoption in reality? So we can identify the simple or complex contagion in reality. So that is our first motivation. So we search a lot of references. So we find one real example of contagion process in Facebook. In Facebook, March 2030, there was a large movement to support same-sex marriage. So a user in Facebook changed their profile picture to support same-sex marriage. Okay. This is an example of profile. So for a user in Facebook changed their his or her profile like this figure, and then neighbor of this user saw the changing and they also adopt this profile. So eventually, many people use the same profile figure, so nobody can distinguish who is who anymore. So within a week, more than 3 million users changed their profile figure, profile picture. And until now, this is the largest single contagion process on Facebook. And fortunately, Facebook research team recorded all of these cascading processes and analyzed this phenomena. And they published this record in 2015. In this paper, there are a lot of interesting results, but we are focused on the number of exposures for adoption. They show this figure in that paper, and this figure show that cumulative distribution with respect to number of exposures. In this talk, we define number of exposures as adaptability. First of all, the distribution of adaptability is really broad. And second, we cannot say simply this process is simple or contagion, because a certain fraction, about 10% of nodes, change their profile at the first exposure, but the rest of people change their profile after multiple exposures. So the adaptability is really heterogeneous, so we may need to propose a mixed contagion process. Mixed means simple. Some nodes are simple contagion, and the other nodes are complex contagion. So we consider contagion process with heterogeneous adaptability, including both simple and complex contagion. So our model unifies a model of simple and complex contagions. And in this talk, for the simplicity, we assume that a p fraction of nodes follow complex contagion. So we called complex nodes, and the other fraction, complementary fraction, 1 minus p of nodes follow simple contagion, so-called simple nodes. Okay, this is an example of our model. Initially, all nodes are susceptible, state, except one seed node, denoted by star. And square is complex node, and circle is simple node. And then adaptive node tried to spread this new information to its neighbor. Then if the trial is successful, the simple node adapts the new information. So it becomes adaptive state, red node. But the complex node does not change its state because it needs multiple exposure. In this example, we assume the number of exposure is 2. So complex node needs 2 exposures. So and in figure B, there are two newly adapted nodes. And next step, these two newly adapted nodes tried to spread again. And then in figure C, this complex node here becomes adapted because it received 2 trials. And then this process goes on and until there is no newly adapted node. So finally, we measure the final fraction of adapted nodes in the system. And then there are some important parameters in this process. P is a fraction of complex node, and N is the number of exposure for a complex node. And lambda is the probability of transmission, and rho is an initial fraction of adapted node, initial fraction of seed node. So we, oh, model is clear. Okay, not clear. Okay, then we developed a mean field type theory for this process. Here R is the final fraction of adapted nodes at the steady state. Let me skip the details of the derivation. And if you are interested in the derivation, you can find it in this preprint. But I would like to give the main idea of this approach. If we want to calculate the probability of adoption for node I, we have to know the state of all of neighbor of node I, denoted by green nodes. But if we want to know the state of this green node, we further need to know the neighbor of neighbor, gray nodes. So we can write down the recursive equation for this type process. So it is, so we should know the probability that a node is adopted by following this link at step n. So we can write down this self-consistency equation. And the philosophy of this method is the same as Bethe approximation in speed models or cavity method in speed model. Anyway, if we solve this recursive equation by iteration and we put this fixed point into this equation, then we can obtain the final fraction of adapted nodes. This approach is exact on tree structure, and it's really good approximation for locally tree-like structure. Okay, for
did you say that the procedure to solve this equation was self-consistent?
Yes.
I don't see it. So what is being, in a self-consistent process, you have some guess for some quantity, and then you make several iterations, and you see if it checks with the...
Well, we assume the structure is... it's kind of annealed approximation, so we assume that network structure is given by just degree distribution. If we calculate the if we want to know the probability of adaptive state or by following this link, this probability is the same as the probability of this node by following of this link. The probability of adoption of this node by following this link is statistically the same as the probability of adoption by following this link. So we can write down a recursive equation for the whole network. Okay, but on L-dash Rennie graph, these equations can be simplified. Here, gamma is gamma function and incomplete gamma function. And we further assume that distribution of adaptability is double delta function, meaning that p fraction of nodes is complex node and 1 minus p fraction of nodes is simple node. Then we can find the final equation like this. Here p and lambda and rho are the same as previous, and z is average degree of L-dash Rennie graph. Okay, then if we define f of r as like this, then the zeros of this function correspond to the fixed point. So without a serious calculation, we can identify that r is zero is always solution, is non-adoption, phase. So stability of this solution is given by the first derivative of f of r. So if first derivative of f of r is less than zero, this solution is stable. If not, this solution is unstable. So transition point is given by f of r, first derivative of f of r is zero. And we can find the transition point like this. If n is one, meaning that all nodes are simple process, simple quantization process, then we can recover the transition point of SIR model. And if n is larger than one, we can find different transition point with additional 1 minus p term. Okay, in the more specific example, this is n is 2 case. We can find the two phases, non-adoption phase and adoption phase. And transition line is given by here. And the nature of transition can be identified by second derivative of f of r. So we find that if p is less than 0.5, the transition is continuous. But if p is larger than 0.5, meaning that the majority is complex node, the transition becomes discontinuous. So also we find a critical point where discontinuous transition changes to continuous transition at p is 0.5 here, circle. So if n is 2, we find discontinuous and continuous transition and criticality. And the critical point is given by this equation, this value. Okay, if n is larger than 2, the story is different. We still find lambda 1 transition always denoted by dashed line in this phase diagram. But if n is larger than 2, this lambda 1 transition is always continuous. But we find another transition which is discontinuous denoted by solid line for different n. So if n is larger than 2, we always find two transitions. One is at lambda 1, which is continuous, and the other one is lambda 2, which is discontinuous. And this discontinuous transition also shows the scaling behavior like following this equation. So this discontinuous equation shows both property of both first order and second order transition, meaning that discontinuous jump and scaling behavior at the same time. This type of phase transition is called by mixed or hybrid phase transitions because it shows both property of transitions. And so in summary, if n is larger than 2, we find continuous transition and hybrid transition, and we also find critical point where this continuous transition disappears. Okay, I know. Okay, so we find a lot of different type of phase transition and critical behavior. So this model shows a dual phase transitions. And another important, another interesting property is that if, for instance, if n is 4, and if we fix p is 0.8, around 0.8, and by varying lambda, we should meet two transitions. One is continuous and the other one is discontinuous. So we examine the mechanism of this double transition. Okay, this is the, I think this will be helpful to understand. The left figure shows the size of adapted node as a function of lambda at p is 0.8, and right figure shows p is 0.4. So when p is 0.8, we find two transitions, lambda 1 and lambda 2, and below lambda 1, no nodes become adapted state except seed node. So all nodes are susceptible state. And above lambda 1, simple node starts to become adapted state. And at lambda 2, both simple and complex nodes become adapted state abruptly. So in between lambda 1 and lambda 2, there is an intermediate phase where simple nodes become adapted, but complex nodes remain susceptible state. But if I am sorry, this is complex node. This is complex node. Yes. And if p is 0.4, there is only one transition, and we find mixed phase. Some simple node becomes adapted, and some complex node becomes adapted. Okay. Let me summarize our result. We study a model of contagion process unifying simple and complex contagions. And we find a rich variety of phase transitions, such as continuous, discontinuous, and hybrid phase transition, criticality, and tricriticality. And we also find intermediate phase where simple node become adapted, but complex node remains susceptible. The main message of our model is that the real world contagion process can be much more complex than expected in solely simple or solely complex contagion model. Okay. I would like to start second part of my talk with these figures. It shows, okay, as we know, there are a lot of social networking services or messenger app in the world, like Facebook, WhatsApp, and Twitter, and so on. So if you want to launch a new technology or a new social networking service, then you have to compete with pre-existing one. It's not a special example. If you want to make a new technology, there is always competitors. And another interesting feature is that in this survey, they found that many people use multiple apps at the same time. In this survey, more than half people use multiple apps frequently. The reason is simple. Reason is different friends use different apps, so I use multiple apps. So we study the effect of competition and dual users in complex contagion process. Dual user means user who use multiple apps at the same time. So we introduce two different rules of transition. So the main difference, important thing of our model is that initially some nodes has already pre-existing pre-existing technology. So some nodes are initially in null state, but some nodes have another technology, which is we call it A technology. So, and at T is zero, B technology starts to spread. And for the we propose two models. One is compatible and the other one is exclusive. In the compatible model, if null state, if a node is in null state, it becomes B state. It becomes B state if the fraction of B neighbor is larger than a threshold, like a usual threshold model. But if a node already possesses A technology, it becomes a B state by adopting B technology if neighbor of B, B neighbor is larger than a threshold. And a B state further becomes B state if a fraction of A neighbor is less than a threshold of A. So A B state represents a dual usual state. But in the exclusive model, these both requirements are imposed simultaneously. So if a node is in A state, it becomes B state only. It can become B state only if neighbor of B state is larger than a fraction of B neighbor is larger than a threshold B, and a fraction of A neighbor is less than threshold of A. So by comparing these two models, we will examine the effect of competition and dual usuals in contagion processes. And we developed a similar mean field theory as previous, but we in this case we include multiple state dynamics. And details is in this archive. Okay, we can expect four different phases. Null phase means A and B, non-adapted phase. And A phase means no spreading of B, but no extinction of A. So A, survival of A and no spreading of B. And B phase means spreading of B and extinction of A. And finally, A plus B, coexistence phase means spreading of B and no extinction of A. Okay, this figure should find a fraction of B adapters and A adapter as a function of rho A. Rho A is initial fraction of A. And we can expect two different transitions. One is for spreading of B, and the other one is extinction of A. And we can identify these transition by looking at the peak of number of iteration of mean field equation. So for instance, in this red curve, where theta B is 0.16, we can find two peaks. One peak for transition of A extinction, and the other peak for transition of B spreading. So in between these two peaks, we can find a coexistence A plus B phases. But if theta B is 0.22 in green line, two transition merges at the same point, and so there is no coexistence phase. In the exclusive model, we always find two peaks in number of iterations, and we always find coexistence phase. This phase diagram will be more easy. This phase diagram is easier to understand. This phase diagram represents phases of compatible and exclusive model as a function of rho A and theta B. Here, A phases means both compatible and exclusive model shows A phases, and B phases, both models show B phases. But phases 1, 2, and 3 are different. Phases 1 represent compatible model shows B phases, but exclusive model shows A phase. And phase B represent compatible model shows B phase, but exclusive model shows mixed coexistence phase. And phase 3 represents compatible model shows coexistence phase, but exclusive model shows A phase. So phase 1 shows that dual users in compatible model lead to A extinction and spreading of B. And phase 2 showed that dual users in compatible models destroy coexistence A plus B phase in favor of full spreading of B. And phase 3 represents dual users spread B and create coexistence phase. So in general, dual users in compatible model promote the spread of new technology B, and at the same time promote the extinction of pre-existing technology A. You can check this effect with different mean degree. Okay, the upper panel is compatible model and below panel is exclusive model with the same index. For the exclusive model with this parameter, A does not goes to does not go to extinction. So A RA always maintains the high fraction larger than 0.5, but B can spread within this area. So in this area, we can find A plus B phase. And if the network is getting dense, no node can initiate the cascading. So above this second transition, there is no spread of B. But in the compatible model, dual user can promote the extinction of A. So the A denoted by red curve decreases rapidly, and B, and we also find full spreading of B phase in compatible model. So it is in general dual user in compatible model promotes spread of B and extinction of A. So in summary, okay, we study a model of complex contagion with competition and dual users. And competition with pre-existing technology suppresses the spread of new innovation, but dual user can promote the spread of new innovation. So message is that if you want to propose a new theory or new model, do not ask to change totally from the old one, but offer it as a good compatible alternative, then people can easily accept your new idea. Okay, and the details are in these two preprint. Yeah, that's it. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. Any questions or comments?
Are there some statistical data about examples, for example, for the technologies where, let's say, the evolution in the competition between two technologies follows such trends as predicted?
Well, I couldn't find any.
For example, messengers, or it would be classical examples, that there would be some statistical data about the spread in time.
As a function of time. Mm-hmm. If we find that example, it will be really good support of our model, but so far we couldn't find any example.
I guess that the answer is, again, in this mechanism, what's the role of the dual users? I think one does not intend to go beyond that. Okay. More questions or comments? Yes.
If I understood well, in the first model you were using an SI model, because, well, they were not recovered. So imagine that you can recover to the state S. Can you guess if you will continue having this continuous transition?
Yes, I think so. I didn't check that seriously, but I think we can observe this continuous and similar behavior for SIS type model. Maybe that actually that's one of my next topic.
Anything else? Comment? Questions? Well, if not, thank you very much for your talk.
Thank you.
Ya.